Now, we talked a lot about the different forms of water. There's liquid water, which we're probably all most familiar with, and that's just regular water. There's also solid water, which we talked about earlier, the glaciers and all of the ice formations. There's also a third form called gas, and the gas is water vapor. So things that, mist and things like that are in the air, that is water vapor. The oceans contain 97% of the water on the Earth. And only 1% of the water on the Earth is actually drinkable as fresh water. So most of the water is salt water in the oceans. And global warming is affecting the levels of our oceans and playing havoc with them. They've also inspired movies like Nemo. There are many diverse creatures, such as sea slugs. There are many kinds of fish in the ocean also, along with giant jellyfish. Now, if the ocean gets polluted, it's filled with animals that we eat. There are predator and prey in the ocean also. Sometimes unknowing fish become the trap of sharks. They circle the fish, and then they attack. Did you know that we're using the same water over and over again? Water on the Earth today has been here for millions of years. There's a thing called the water cycle. It moves from Earth to the air and back to the Earth again. Rivers, lakes, and oceans lose water every day through evaporation. Then, after it's been evaporated, there's condensation, where the water collects in the clouds. Then the clouds produce water vapor that becomes liquid or precipitation and creates thunderstorms. To protect the water that is on Earth without making sure it doesn't get polluted, making sure that we conserve it, then we will have a great future, and so will our kids, of having lovely things like great flowers and fruit trees, things that we can eat, and have plenty of food to eat. Another thing that a thunderstorm does is that it creates beautiful rainbows. Now, if you don't know it, you need to have water in order to have a rainbow. That's why you always see a rainbow when it rains. To view a rainbow, you must have the sun to your back. You look up at about 40 degrees, and then there's got to be water droplets in the air. So there has to be some kind of mist that then the little droplets look like prisms, and they create rainbows. And the colors of the rainbow go red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Red, move downstage. Red, move downstage. Move downstage. Move downstage. They have more room. Excellent. And set the claws down. Set them down upstage. We're going to move on to our finale now. Our finale has an A phrase, which is a punching phrase that represents the driving precipitation or rain. So it's a series of punches. Then we have a B phrase, which is a jumping phrase. So that's the gas form. That's the evaporation. And then we repeat the A phrase or the punches. So it'll go punches, jumps, and punches. Dancers call this ABA choreography. You guys ready? Okay, the music is by Herbie Hancock. Ready, position. What would a Chicago water program be without the Chicago Water Tower? Look up and smile, look up and smile. And arms go up, give them a hand, and over, and up, and the wave. Stay down, stay down, stay down. And sit. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody. Let's give one more round of applause to all of our student performers today. Very much for coming to Water's Way, our program today. If we could have the lights up in the house, that would be wonderful. And there they are. Thank you again for coming. I hope that you've been inspired to think about your life and the ways that you use water and how it is around you. I want to again thank the Gary C. Comer family, to thank Columbia College, and to thank all of you for coming out today. So give yourselves a round of applause for everything that you've done.